most vaccines work by teaching the body's immune system to help you defend against infection. But they use one part of the immune system called antibodies. We're trying to develop vaccines that use another part of the immune system called T cells. And these T cells can resist AIDS, malaria, other infections. They can resist cancer as well. And in our research, we discovered a new type of cell, dendritic cells, that teaches the T cells how to make a response. They help the T cell initiate immunity, and they control the type of immunity. So our new vaccines are designed to harness these features of dendritic cells and thereby give us new T cell-based vaccines. In the past, the way a vaccine against polio or influenza, smallpox, etc., is made is that you use a weakened form of the virus. But this isn't possible with the AIDS virus and with other agents. So what our vaccines are doing is taking apart the virus into the components that need to be recognized by the T cells that I mentioned, and also the components that teach the dendritic cell how to initiate an immune response. So in summary, we're developing new protein-based vaccines against AIDS, and the platform we're developing can extend to other infections and to cancer. When the AIDS epidemic arrived, it took us several years till we decided that our research could bear upon the AIDS problem. And initially, what our lab did was try to understand how the cells we study, which are dendritic cells, how they might contribute to the disease AIDS itself. And what we found was that the dendritic cells can actually pick up the AIDS virus and take it to the T cells where the virus then replicates. The virus, the main home for the virus are these T cells. And that's why AIDS is such a bad disease, because it incapacitates T cells, which are a very important defense mechanism. But then after we had done this work, other research in the lab indicated that we could use dendritic cell science not just to understand how the disease develops, but perhaps how to prevent the disease with a vaccine. And particularly work that we are doing with the laboratory of Michel Nussenzweig has led to this strategy that I outlined, which is to take components of the virus or cancer cells in the future, but take those components and learn to direct them to the dendritic cell and to teach the dendritic cell so that it can elicit a strong T-cell mediated immune response. Our hope is first to help develop an AIDS vaccine. This has been a long-standing and really challenging problem. One part of the problem is that we don't know how to elicit T-cell immunity. So a second hope I have is that by learning to do this in the setting of an AIDS vaccine, will it be able to extend our research to other vaccine needs. Malaria and tuberculosis, leishmaniasis, are all infectious diseases that are in our research strategy. And above all, we also want to bring vaccines to the field of cancer. Cancer immunology is ripe with potential to help patients resist their tumors. But we need to design approaches in humans to test the capacity of the immune system to bring this about. We took another approach to dendritic cell vaccination, to use dendritic cell science in vaccines, which involved growing dendritic cells from a patient or a volunteer, charging them with antigens, let's say a cancer antigen or an HIV antigen, and then reinfusing their own dendritic cells to immunize their immune systems. And these studies were done by Madhav Dodapkar and Nina Bardwaj in our hospital. And in each case, the patients came into the hospital, we injected the dendritic cells, and when we followed them for, you know, 1 or 2 days in the hospital, because again, these were first in humans studies. And recently, the first dendritic cell-based vaccine of this type receive licensure from the FDA. It's the first example that active immunization of humans, and in this case they were patients with advanced prostate cancer, could prolong life. It really established a proof of concept to the satisfaction of the FDA that had to license the procedure. And I think this licensing holds a lot of promise because it really is a first generation of this approach, and the approach only currently uses one antigen, only one protein from the prostate cancer cell. So therefore, if we improve the technology and improve the number of antigens, I suspect we can do a lot better. The new approach that we're intensifying and emphasizing now, together with the Nusenswag lab, is, you could say, much simpler. We're learning to direct vaccine proteins to the dendritic cells in the patient. So we don't have to take out the dendritic cells or make them outside of the body. It's much simpler to make a vaccine that knows to go to the dendritic cell and knows to be delivered with other stimuli that the dendritic cell needs to teach the immune system to protect us. And this approach, we think, is not only simpler, but more amenable to translation into global infections and much broader and simpler use. Cell research is really an active area of research worldwide. There are thousands of scientists, many laboratories, and even many biotech and other companies interested in dendritic cell research. What we want to do at Rockefeller is remain innovative. Try to bring new features, discover new features of dendritic cell biology, and in addition, always keep our eye on a disease, including vaccine approaches. We're not the only ones, but that's our focus, and that's the one, and as I mentioned, it's a tremendous advantage being here to pursue that emphasis.